Well, hey gang, how you doing? It's Jonathan again from Tail Hunter International. Time once again for the Mexican Minute La Paz Video Fishing Report, coming to you from La Paz, Baja, Mexico. And this is going to cover all of the fishing action for this past week of the 5th through the 12th of August, 2018. Hope wherever you are, you're doing well. Thanks for checking in. Thanks for subscribing. Let's talk about fishing. The big story this week, well, it wasn't so much fishing. Yes, we had fishing. Fishing was going along pretty nicely. And then all of a sudden, you know, kind of just like a relative who shows up and you don't really want to see them. And we knew there were going to be some rainstorms this week. We knew there were going to be a couple of showers, no big deal. We were keeping an eye on it. Well, all of a sudden these rain showers that we were going to get throughout the week, they're going to be intermittent and on and off and really not affect us too badly. Well, it got a name, and the name of it was Hurricane John. Hurricane John showed up out of nowhere. It was a Category 1 hurricane, not a big hurricane by some of the standards we've had, but enough that it was going to mess things up. It was coming right for us. It came out of nowhere. Eventually, it kind of glanced off and went out towards the Pacific, but it was enough, and it had those big, you know, swirly arms that hurricanes have, that it really kind of messed things up. It shut us down for a couple of days. It brought some winds. We had water spouts. We had thunder. We had lightning. Not a terrible, terrible storm, but enough that we had to shut things down. The port captain closed the port for a couple days. And for the rest of the week, even after it disappeared, like I said, it didn't drop a lot on us. But it was, you know, like I said, one of those relatives who shows up unannounced, and then they say they're going to be not a big bother, but then they kind of hang on. They just kind of get in your way. Well, that's the way Hurricane John was all week. This is really kind of the first day. You can see the ocean behind me. The wind's kind of coming up a little strong, but this is really the first sunny day we've had all week. Throughout the week, we had clouds, we had intermittent showers, we had some thunder, some lightning. Yesterday, today is Sunday, I'm doing this fishing report, but yesterday it was raining in the morning. We're trying to put the boats out. Guys are going, hey, are we still fishing? And we're going, hey, don't worry about it. I know it's thunder, there's lightning, we're getting soaking wet, but things are going to get better. Don't worry about it. You're going to be able to fish. But honestly, we, you know, so many days we really didn't know if we were going to be able to fish, or other days where we had everybody ready. We had, you know, a dozen boats ready to go. We had all the fishermen and all of the hotels ready to get out, and they're anxious to go fishing. They've been cooped up for a while. And then we really didn't tell them that we really didn't know if we were going to be able to get out, because we didn't know if the port captain was even going to open the port, or if he was going to shut the port down because the weather conditions were changing. So overall, we did get out. We lost a couple of days, but we thank everybody for being really patient. It's just one of those things that comes up. We can't control the weather. I wish we could. Wish we could just, you know, wave a magic wand and make the weather perfect all the time. But it's just one of those things that comes with going out fishing or living here in a tropical area. So Hurricane John, it seems like it's gone, but it's still leaving us with some winds. And throughout the week, it did leave us with some intermittent showers and thunder and lightning. But we did get some fishing. So, you know, everybody got some fish. It wasn't great fishing by any stretch of the imagination. It wasn't as good as it had been before the storm, but it wasn't terribly bad either. Over at Las Arenas, the big tuna were still there, although they still are a little picky, but the nice size tuna, 40 to 50 pounders, some 60 pounders in there as well, had a couple 80-ish pounders. We'll never know, because they were pulling for a long time and we lost them. But what happened was we had some nice football tuna showed up, and those were fun fish, 15, 20 pound footballers right at the Las Arenas Lighthouse area. We also had some bigger Dorado in the 10 to 25 pound class over at Las Arenas. And the really strange thing is we started getting some of these Pargolisa and some Pompano. Now these are fish that are normally cooler water fish that we don't see until the springtime, but we got some this week, and that was a nice surprise. Over here at La Paz, where I'm standing right now, right on the shore at La Paz Bay, once again, typical of this time of year, warm waters, warm temperatures, the Dorado were the centerpiece. So most of the fishing on this side was probably 90% Dorado, and nice sized fish. Some smaller ones in the, you know, 5, 7, 8 pound class, we call them Doraditos. And then some nicer fish in the 20 pound class, kept everybody busy, kept everybody happy, and that helped fill the fish boxes for the week. So everybody got fish. It wasn't fantastic fishing, but nobody really complained. Everybody was able to get out, and that's the kind of the fishing report. what's really going to tell the story is take a look at some of the photos, take a look at the rest of this video, check out the fishing gallery, and you'll see what kind of fish we were getting this week. That's going to wrap it up for our Mexican Minute La Paz Video Fishing Report. This is Jonathan for Tailhunter Sport Fishing. Hope you're having a great week. Take care of each other. Be good to each other. God bless. Thanks a lot for checking in.